Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are doing very well. This is Sangeeta Mahawar, your English teacher, and today we are going to start a new lesson of your textbook, that is lesson 7, Birbal and the Holy Parrot. Dear students, in this lesson, we will get a story which is about a holy parrot and Birbal. Birbal was one of the ministers in the court of Emperor Akbar. He was famous for his intelligence and sense of humor. Birbal is the person who saves the lives of people from the anger of the king. Birbal is very wise as well as clever man. So let's get moved towards the beautiful story. First we will take the reading part, but before reading of this story, we will take some hard words of this lesson. First, holy, pierce, gift, present, be had, to cut off one's head, attendant, a person whose job is to serve others. So now, student, we will move to our reading part of this chapter. Students, put your fingers where I'm reading. One day, Akbar's favorite attendant came to Birbal. He was almost in tears. Hazur, Hazur, you have got to help me. Only you can save my life. Birbal said, yes, go on. A few months ago, the emperor gave me a parrot. It is very special bird, a holy man's gift to me. Take good care of it. The emperor said to that attendant, if anyone brings me news of its death, I will behead him, said the king. And now, in spite of my loving care, it suddenly dies. What shall I do? Is that all? Leave it to me. I will take the news to the emperor and yet save your head. Jahanpana, do you remember the parrot that Fakir gave you? It's a holy bird indeed. It is Jahanpana. I had gone to see it, and do you know what is it does? It meditates like a saint. A holy bird indeed, ha ha ha, said the king to Birbal. So the two went to the attendant house. When Akbar saw the bird, even now it is meditating with its eyes closed and its head turned down, said Birbal to Akbar the great king. Birbal, you may be wise and clever, but there is a limit, said Akbar to Birbal. And the attendant was seeing the talking of the Akbar and the Birbal. The bird is dead, and don't tell me you didn't know it, said Akbar to Birbal. Birbal replied, I did, but I didn't want to be beheaded. Only then did Akbar remember what he had told his attendant. Well, you have saved yet another head, Birbal, and I am grateful to you for it. So Akbar replied to Birbal these, that well, you have saved yet another head, Birbal, and I am grateful to you. So by this, Birbal saved the life of attendant. Now students, we will move to the explanation part of this beautiful story. A person was very fond of parrots. He used to catch them and sell them to the interested people. One time he got parrot from the jungle. He trained him talking and presenting him to the king. That he told to the king that it is a very smart parrot. He can speak as well as give answers to your question. The king becomes happy seeing that parrot and take the parrot to him. The king made special arrangements for his safety as well as security and warned all the people, if somebody will tell me about his dad, he will be hanged. Hearing this, the parrot was kept under very special care. But it so happened that one day the parrot suddenly died. Now, the caretaker who is taking care start crying and go to the Birbal that please save me, because whoever will inform the king about the death of parrot will be sentenced to be dead, said the attendant to the Akbar. Attendant said, if I inform him about the parrot's death, then the king will kill me, and if I not, then also he will kill me. So please save me, Birbal, please save me. Now Birbal went to the king and said to the king that Japana, your parrot neither eat nor drink. He is meditating and nor he open his feathers as well as eyes. So king said to Birbal, you are wise and clever. I know that, Akbar, but there is a limit. Tell me if the parrot is dead. Birbal said, I have not said that. That you have said that the parrot is dead. I don't want. So Birbal and Akbar was talking, and Birbal said that I don't want to be cut off one's head, king understand, and said, well, you save the life of some and make not to punish him. I grateful to you because that attendant was innocent. There is no fault of that attendant in the death of this parrot. So student, this is the English explanation part. Now we will move to a short Hindi summary of this story. एक जंगल में एक आदमी तोता पकड़ता, उन्हें सिखाता और बेच दिया करता था। एक बार उसके हाथ एक बड़ा सुंदर तोता लगा। उसने तोता पकड़ा और उसे सिखाया और बादशाह अकबर के सामने पेश किया। बादशाह को वह तोता बहुत ही पसंद आया क्योंकि वह तोता उत्तर देता था। बादशाह ने तोते की देखरेख के लिए एक सेवक रखा और कहा, यदि यह तोता मर गया तो मैं तुम्हें भी मार दूंगा और जो व्यक्ति यह खबर लाएगा उसे भी मैं नहीं छोड़ूंगा। सेवक तोते को अपने साथ ले गया और उसकी खूब सेवा की, परंतु एक दिन वह तोता अचानक मर गया। रखवाला सेवक घबरा गया। वह बिरबल के पास पहुंचा, सारी बात बताते हुए बोला, अब मेरी जान कोई नहीं बचा सकता, मुझे आप ही बचा सकते हो। अगर मैं तोते की मौत की खबर दूंगा राजा को, तब भी मारा जाऊंगा, और ना दी तब भी मैं मारा जाऊंगा। तो अब मैं क्या करूं? एक आप ही हो जो मुझे बचा सकते हो। तो बिरबल बोले, तुम टेंशन ना लो, मैं सब कुछ संभाल लूंगा। अगले दिन बिरबल बादशाह के पास पहुंचा और बोला, जहां पना वह तोता, तुम्हारा वह तोता। और यह आगे की लाइन उसने अधूरी छोड़ दी। फिर कहा, वह तोता आपका मेडिटेशन कर रहा है संत की तरह। बादशाह हंसने लगे, हा हा हा, ऐसा कैसे हो सकता, एक तोता और मेडिटेशन। फिर बादशाह देखने गए, उन्होंने वहां जाके देखा कि तोता जरा सा भी अपनी जगह से हल नहीं रहा था, या फिर मूव नहीं कर रहा था। तो बादशाह ने बिरबल को कहा कि तुम वाइज और क्लेवर हो, पर इतने भी तेज और चतुर नहीं हो। मैं जानता हूँ कि ये तोता मर चुका है। क्या ये तोता मर गया है बिरबल, और तुम्हें ये चीज पता है? तो बिरबल ने बोला कि मैंने तो ऐसा नहीं कहा कि ये तोता मर गया है, पर अगर आप कह रहे हो तो सही में ये तोता मर गया होगा। तब बिरबल बोला कि यह तोता तो मर गया है। बिरबल ने ये बात नहीं बोली, पर राजा ने ये चीज कबूल कर ली थी। फिर राजा ने बोला कि बिरबल तुमने ऐसा क्यों किया? तो बिरबल ने बोला कि मैं एक बेकसूर को मरने नहीं दे सकता था। आपने कहा था कि जो भी इसकी मौत की खबर लाएगा उसे मैं नहीं छोड़ूंगा, और इसमें जो सेवा करने वाला था उसकी कोई गलती नहीं थी, क्योंकि रखवाले ने तो उसकी रक्षा की थी, पर तोता फिर भी मर गया, इसलिए उस रखवाले की कोई गलती नहीं है, वह बेकसूर है। तोता अपनी मौत खुद मरा है। बादशाह ने रखवाले को माफ कर दिया और कहा कि मैं तुम्हें माफ करता हूँ, इसमें तुम्हारी कोई गलती नहीं है। और इसी तरह बिरबल की चतुराई से रखवाला बच गया। उसने बिरबल का शुक्रिया किया और कहा कि शुक्रिया बिरबल, आज अगर तुम नहीं होते तो मैं मर चुका होता। सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ अकबर बिरबल एंड द होली पैरट। Students, if there is any doubt or query related to this chapter, you can ask me anytime.